Researchers in the Karolinska Medical Research Institute in Sweden discovered what they think might be a driver of inflammation. Not so much a root cause like inflammatory diseases or prediabetes, but a metabolic driver, one of those final common pathways which creates and stimulates inflammation. We've known for a while that inflammation was the real cause of heart attack and stroke, more so than LDL and more so than some of the other things. We also know that in terms of root causes, insulin resistance, prediabetes is a bigger driver than anything else. Smoking used to be a big driver and it's growing again. Inflammatory diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, those are drivers. And yes, familial hypercholesterolemia does create some of this as well. When you look at the history, we've known this for 20 years or more. This is a cover 2004 of the Time magazine talking about it. It's just that the medical community doesn't really understand what to do about it yet. Here's a diagram showing the progression of an artery from no plaque to developing plaque to this reddish area where you're getting inflammation of the plaque. Now, the researchers at Karolinska Institute said they discovered one of the proteins that's used to drive this spiraling increase of inflammation. They found it in endothelial cells and they found it in media cells. Remember, the endothelium is the lining of the artery wall. It's also called the intima. And the media is a smooth muscle, which protects the artery from blowing up. I mean, you have the lining of the artery and the strength sec layer of the artery. The next few slides are just going to show pictures. Again, the muscle layer and the endothelial layer. And as you see in here, lots of areas where their arrows are pointing out where they're seeing CARD8. This is the lining of the artery wall. This is the media or muscle cell layer. And again, CARD8 being discovered in the lining, in the media area, multiple areas of these artery walls. Now, these arteries were taken from human subjects in the carotid area with biopsies. Now, we've known about inflammation for 157 years, well, closer to 160 years. Virchow, quote, the father of pathology and the father of public health, postulated this 160 years ago, that cardiovascular disease was really an inflammatory process. But then we took a hard detour and we went down that path of Ansel Keys, looking at the, quote, the fat in the artery wall and deciding this was fat and cholesterol and that that must have come from cholesterol that we were eating in the diet. That theory got debunked and now we're having debates and arguments about whether we eat too much fats, too many carbs, etc. The bottom line is, it still hasn't changed. We know that inflammation's a driver. We just don't know on a medical what to do about it basis, what to do about it. So again, as I said, what we want is a crystal clean artery like you see down on this end. But unfortunately, as we get closer to a heart attack, you get this end where there's been pile up of this LDL between the intima lining and the media layer. This is all LDL, and again, it's had inflammation. Inflammatory cells have come in. They've released cytokines and enzymes to digest that plaque. Here's pictures of path slides, real human arteries where this has happened. Intima lining, the media lining, and this gray stuff in between the intima and media is plaque. Here you see an area where the immune system has attacked this plaque and it's liquefied it. That plaque, when liquefied, if it goes back out into the bloodstream, can cause a clot, which can cause a heart attack. The clot's big enough, goes to the heart, it's a heart attack, and big enough, goes to the brain, it's a stroke. Here's my own inflammation study from a couple of years ago. We look at myeloperoxidase, plaque 2 activity. Those are both enzymes, which I'll show you in just a minute, that are being released by specific cells. Plaque 2 by the macrophages, myeloperoxidase by what we call neutrophils. High sensitivity C-reactive protein is just a protein created by the liver. And microalbumin creatinine ratio actually shows whether or not we're spilling protein into the urine. And I'll show you why. If we're spilling protein into the urine, we're probably spilling LDL cholesterol from the bloodstream into the artery wall. Here's some of the lab slips that come back to show that. I mentioned microalbumin creatinine ratio. Each kidney is a million filters. Each filter looks like this. It's just an artery coming down into a collection system. That media section peels off, and the filter membrane itself is the intima or endothelial layer. If protein spills into the urine, albumin is the most common protein in the blood. So we know that there is injury or porosity to the filter membrane. That in turn means that there's some damage to that filter membrane. We talked about LPPLA2, plaque 2. This is a diagram of an artery with the blood flow here and the plaque here and the intima right there, the endothelial cells. Macrophages slip through those endothelial cells and bury themselves within the plaque. They then start releasing enzymes. And those enzymes, again, if there's too much of this activity, you can get spewing of this hot, soft plaque into the bloodstream. When Tim Russert died from his heart attack, they said the inside of his arteries looked like the pimply face of a teenager with acne. Again, plaque 2, same diagram, a little bit different perspective, but this is how this inflammation happens. Myeloperoxidase, again, very same process where white cells are becoming attracted to the intima lining of the artery wall. When inflammation is going on, cytokines, these things, attract those. They then slip through the intima cell into the what we call the media or the intima media space. This is what it looks like under a microscope. These black dots are neutrophils laden with myeloperoxidase. As we mentioned, another inflammatory marker is C-reactive protein, again, made by the liver. Now, here's the thing. There's a fellow named Paul Ridker at Harvard who's been doing a lot of work for a couple of decades looking at inflammation. He got the idea a few years ago to use canakinumab. It's one of those very expensive anti-inflammatory drugs used for some unusual inflammatory diseases. He actually saw a significant decrease in heart attack and stroke among people that got the study group, the people that got the anti-inflammatory. But unfortunately, those same people had decreased immune function and many of them died due to infections. So that's not something that's going to be coming up anytime soon. They've actually tried it. I've got a couple of friends who are close to that activity, and that is still being debated with the FDA. Bottom line is, this whole subject of inflammation is a big deal. Is CARD8 going to uncover some new secrets for us so we understand it better? Is it going to give us clues to an intervention where we can maybe disable CARD8 to decrease this inflammatory process? Maybe it will. Thank you for your interest. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. The Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning, preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs, we go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.